At this place in history, we're in Williston with Executive Director of the Vermont Historical Society, Steve Perkins. One recognizable name, but we're talking about a different one today, and that is Thomas Chittenden.
Thomas Chittenden, we've all heard that name. At least we've heard the last name. We always talk about Chittenden County, certainly named after this guy. But there's a big, huge monument behind me dedicated to the first governor of the state of Vermont.
Was he born right here in Williston?
So early that he was not. He was born in East Guilford, Connecticut. He then moved to Salisbury, Connecticut. He had a number of children. He got married down there. He was a colonel in the militia and then ended up moving to Williston in 1774.
How did he get involved in politics then?
So is this thing going on between New York and New Hampshire about who owned this land that we now call Vermont. Since he bought his land from Ira Allen, it meant that he got his land patent from New Hampshire. So he signed with the folks from New Hampshire Grants. We've all heard of Ethan Allen and his Green Mountain Boys. They kicked the Yorkers out of Vermont. So Chittenden was part of that crew. But then this war with England kind of intervened. And as colonists, they got thinking, you know, how do we interact with the home country? Are we a part of the colonies of Great Britain? Are we our own country? And Chittenden became very involved in that. He was president of the first Council of Safety, which helped govern what later became the state of Vermont. And he helped write the Vermont Constitution. So from 1777 to 1791, we're our own independent republic, and Thomas Chittenden, they called him governor, was the head of that government for all but 1 year. And then he had to tread that delicate political balance of how does the Republic of Vermont become the state of Vermont. And so he helped guide the state through that transition, and he then served as governor of this new state of Vermont from 1791 until his death in 1797.
Was he well-liked and respected by people?
As far as we can tell, he was respected. He could read people really well and was very adept at this political maneuvering. I mean, which is evidence because he was governor for so long and really until his death. So Amanda, we're here in Williston on one of the Chittenden original land holdings, and Lucy McCullough, who lives in this house, has gracious enough to chat with us a bit about the history here.
Governor Chittenden's home is about a mile further down Governor Chittenden Road on the bend in the river, and he built this house for son Giles, and there's a little lane right in front of us here that connects over to another Chittenden home, which was the Truman Chittenden home over on Route 2. The main road, which is now Governor Chittenden Road, became the governor's trail to Burlington, started to be used more than the little lane over to Truman's house. So they changed the emphasis of the front of the house from in back of us to the side of what looks like the side of the house.
People can visit the property. This is part of Catamount Outdoor Center.
I'm always happy to give them a little tour of the house and tell them a little bit of the history and some of the changes that have occurred.
Tracing Thomas Chittenden's footsteps at this place in history.